Built wild, the 2021 Ford Bronco Sport.
Review by Larry Nutson, Executive Editor and Bureau Chief of the Auto Channel's Chicago Bureau.
No doubt by now you know that Ford has brought back the Bronco. What might be less known is that Bronco is now a brand comprised of more than just one model. The very first Ford Bronco was introduced for 1966.
The Bronco, a totally new concept in transportation. And versatility is its middle name. The Bronco is a roadster. Wide open, all fun and adventure. The Bronco's a sports utility, ready for any kind of action, with a roof that is removable. With a full roof, the Bronco's a snappy wagon, well-suited for work or play. Excellent as a family car, and the wagon roof is also removable. The Bronco is more than just another new vehicle. It's an all-purpose utility car with four-wheel drive power and traction. Built to go wherever there's a foothold. Tough, strong, and dependable.
The Bronco continued to evolve for over 30 years, growing larger in size until production ended in 1996. Now, today, there are three all-new vehicles that fall under the Bronco brand. One is the four-door Bronco Sport, which is what this review is focused on. The other two are the larger two-door Bronco and the four-door Bronco. Ford calls this trio the Bronco Outdoor brand of built wild SUVs, all of which come standard with a 4x4 drivetrain. The 2021 four-door Bronco Sport compact SUV, often called the Baby Bronco, is unibody construction. It's built on the same architecture as the Ford Escape. However, it's much more rugged. For a perspective, wheelbase is 105.1 inches and overall length is 172.7 inches. The Escape rides on a larger 106.7 inch wheelbase and is 180.5 inches long. The 5-passenger Bronco Sport is available in 5 trims with 2 engines. The base, Big Bend, and Outer Banks trims are powered by a 181 horsepower 1.5 liter 3-cylinder EcoBoost turbo engine. Badlands and First Edition trims have a 250 HP 2-liter 4-cylinder EcoBoost turbo engine. All are equipped with an 8-speed automatic and, as mentioned, all are 4-wheel drive. Every Bronco Sport has selectable drive modes that Ford has named GOAT modes, G-O-A-T, which stands for goes over any type of terrain. All have normal, eco, sport, slippery, and sand modes. The Badlands and First Edition trims have 2 additional modes, mud ruts and rock crawl. Ford has engineered the Bronco Sport for off-road use with short front and rear overhangs, big approach, departure and ramp over angles. It has a minimum ground clearance of 7.8 inches. Badlands and First Edition trims have a standard 8.6 inches and optional 8.8 inches ground clearance, which also then provides increased approach, departure and ramp over angles. These two can travel through up to 23.6 inches of water. Bronco Sport has an independent front and rear suspension. The Badlands and First Edition have uniquely tuned front struts with hydraulic rebound stops for improved off-road driving. Additionally, 46mm diameter monotube rear shocks help provide improved response and more comfort off-road. Softer springs and anti-roll bars offer greater articulation over obstacles. These two trims also have a 4x4 system equipped with a twin-clutch rear drive unit with a differential lock feature. The three lower trims with the 1.5-liter engine are equipped with all-season tires. The top two trims with the 2-liter engine have all-terrain tires. The available 29-inch Falcon Wild Peak all-terrain tires provide the most in off-road capability. In simple terms, the base, Big Bend, and Outer Banks models are more the on-road, moderate, and around-town models. The Badlands and First Edition models have more off-road creds, but are still well-suited for the highway. But make no mistake, all five are plenty rugged and have serious capability out in the wild. Inside the cabin, there is decent seating up front with good outward visibility across the squared-off hood. a center infotainment screen, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, 10-speaker B&O audio, and rotary transmission gear selector plus knobs and switchgear with a rugged look, complete the package. The Ford Co-Pilot 360 suite of advanced driver assist safety technologies is standard across the lineup, including pre-collision assist with automatic emergency braking featuring pedestrian detection, forward collision warning and dynamic brake support, blind spot information system with cross-traffic alert, lane keeping system, auto high beam headlamps, and a rear view camera. For my Bronco Sport Drive experience, I was in the Outer Banks trim. I didn't encounter any sandy desert, rock-strewn hills, or need to cross a small river. My drive was around my Chicago home, on the streets and highways of a big city. On the road, the Bronco Sport is comfortable to drive and easy to maneuver with its compact exterior. The ride is a bit firm, but not overly so. The 1.5-liter engine with its 190 pound-foot of torque does quite well in moving the Bronco Sport. Small engines can tend to be a bit noisy, but not in this case. However, Ford did well in providing a comfortable and slightly throaty overall engine sound. The 8-speed automatic keeps the engine in its best performing operating range, which also helps keep the noise down. EPA fuel economy ratings for the 1.5-liter Bronco Sport are 26 miles per gallon combined, with 25 city mpg and 28 highway mpg. Ford offers more than 100 factory-backed and aftermarket accessories for maximum personalization of your Bronco Sport. Base prices start at $26,820 for the base trim and climb to $38,500 for the first edition, plus $1,495 destination and delivery charge. The Outer Banks trim model I drove had a base price of $32,160 and totaled out at $36,440 as equipped. If I were buying, the Outer Banks would most likely be my choice. However, if I lived in a mountainous area or in an area that got lots of snow, the Badlands version might be the better choice. The added engine power will be a plus in hill country, and the Falcon tires will be better in snow. I've had a fair amount of experience driving various Jeep models, both on and off-road, including rock crawling, stream swimming, plus negotiating mud and sand. Jeep is definitely who Bronco has in their sights. The Bronco Sport seems well outfitted to do a good job at challenging and competing well out in the wide open spaces. As I wrap up this review, we learned that the Bronco Sport has scored a perfect crash test score from the independent non-profit Insurance Institute for Highway Safety with a top pick plus rating. Lastly, coming back to the big Bronco, the 2- and 4-door will very soon be in the market. COVID-19 upset the car business, just as it upset all of us. I've seen the new Bronco in person and crawled around its cabin. I'm looking forward to that drive experience to share with you.
For more information about Ford's new Bronco models, including complete specifications, visit theautochannel.com.